It's 45 days to go before Christmas, and the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints just unveiled its Light the World Giving Machine at a mall in Quezon City and in Cebu, giving mall goers a chance to donate to worthwhile causes as easily as buying from a vendor. Instead of usual drinks and snacks, the giving machine offers donation options, from providing shelter repair kits for victims of Typhoon Egay or prosthetic legs to amputee patients who cannot afford it, to helping fund the college education of military orphans. The project actually started back in 2022 and raised, get this, a whopping $7 million worldwide. And since the Philippines is known for having the longest Christmas season, which officially begins in September, that only means one thing: there is more time to give. Metrobank bullish its credit card business will remain strong in 2024, and sticky inflation and sky-high interest rates will not stop customers from swiping. The TLED bank cites a resilient customer base, the travel boom, and improving economic environment for next year for its rosy outlook.
In 2024, if you look at the plans, you will see that we're very optimistic. The targets for next year during our planning reflects a high degree of confidence on the world opening up, the economy getting a little bit better every day. Even this year, you still see like a growth in customer spend, right? So I think it's a little bit more, at least the portfolio that we have, I think it's a little bit more resilient.
The bank recently relaunched its World MasterCard, which gives exclusive privileges to users. Among those would be complimentary access to over 1,000 airport lounges in the world, luxury dining discounts, and global shopping offers, among others. Metrobank currently has over 1.4 million credit cards in circulation. Economic analysts expecting sustained growth in the Philippine economy until the end of the year. Their bullish outlook comes after that better-than-expected third-quarter GDP print of 5.9%. The economists are betting on holiday consumer spending and foreign direct investments to further boost the economy. They also shared the government's optimism. The 6-7% full-year growth target is still within reach.
That will be more translated into the consumption itself, more than the government spending. So I think 6% is still very attainable. I think the trajectory is there. When I pointed out that consumption has trailing lower, it's still above 5%. So the key here is, as you pointed out, Q4, Christmas spending, it should pick up.
Meanwhile, Global Markets Research Asia is seeing a pause in the Monetary Board's next policy meeting. That's November 16th. It projects the central bank will end the tightening of monetary policy by the second half of next year. The Public Works and Highways Department set to begin the Swiss challenge for the Tarlac-Pangasinan La Union or TP-LEX Expressway Extension Project after receiving the green light from the National Economic and Development Authority. The NEDA Board, chaired by President Marcos himself, has approved the project's parameters, terms, and conditions. The 23.4 billion peso TP-LEX Extension Project covers a 59.4 kilometer lane toll road, aiming to interconnect the Ilocos region, Central Luzon, and Metro Manila, that's set to be completed within 5 years from the contract signing. It aims to stimulate economic activity, mitigate road congestion, and provide safer road access to the public. The project is expected to be awarded to either the original proponent, the San Miguel Holdings Corporation, or to other possible challengers between March to May of next year. Now, this is one of the 197 infrastructure flagship projects of the Marcos administration.